Rana, my introduction to what the most North Indians call the South Indian films was when I was barely like a year old, and my parents took me to watch Roja, which was a Tamil film. Growing up with a very stereotypical view of South Indian movies. Until one day, my father just forced me to go and watch something called Bahubali. And I had no clue at that time what it was. And I went in and I'm just sitting there staring at the screen and I'm just like, is this real? Do you think Bahubali changed the way the rest of India views South Indian movies?
Pagalu Ratriya Neelalo, no, it's not a joke. Neen Kaani, Aadi Kaani, Makru Anta.
So you worked in different industries in India, like you said. What difference did you see between...
I was just amazed at how dumb Indians are about the other state.
Super!
I was just amazed at how dumb Indians are about the other state. Ultimately, it's a camera, it's a story, it's a bunch of actors. You put it here, it's the same format, right? I could speak in Telugu, it becomes a Telugu film. Speak in English, it becomes an English film. That's exactly what happens. Correct?
Yes, but...
Anywhere in the world. But we have, in our heads, made, this is an industry. That's an industry. This is a Telugu industry. What does it make films? This is a Tamil industry. What does it make films? How different is it?
But one day...
Crossing over are completely crossing over. Rajinikanth is making films in all languages. They're dubbing in all languages. Avengers is dubbing in all languages. So which means it's clear that there's actually no boundary to this unless you make one.
Hmm.